So we're continuing to talk about how spatial locations are defined and the challenges that the brain faces when its sensors are moving about in space. So our different sensor types can move, our eyes can move, our head can move, in many species the ears can move as well, and of course the body can move. So when your brain is trying to do something like figure out whether or not something that you see is making a sound that you can hear, or whether or not something that you can touch is the same thing that you can see, the brain has to deal with the fact that the information is coming in through sensors that have a flexible relationship with each other. I'm going to tell you some more about the superior colliculus, the brain area that we've already begun to speak about in several earlier videos. You already know that the superior colliculus plays a role in vision and eye movements, as well as hearing, and today I'm going to tell you more about its role in coordinating between these senses and our sense of touch. When you feel something on your body, a natural response is to try to orient your eyes to look at it, to see what it is that has just touched you. So for example, if you feel the bite of a mosquito, you want to turn your eyes to see whether or not it was a mosquito or was it possibly a bee, and second, what do you need to do to get away from this creature? Well, the simple act of looking at the mosquito is actually a very complicated process. To be able to orient your eyes to the location of where the mosquito is biting your skin, you need to know a number of different things. You need to know the angle of your wrist, of your elbow, of your shoulder, of your neck, and then finally, you need to know the position of your eyes with respect to the head. And it is only upon combining those pieces of information that your brain can figure out exactly what angle to orient your eyes to look at the location of the mosquito. I'm going to tell you a little bit about an experiment that I did when I was a graduate student working with David Sparks. And we were interested in how the position of the eyes with respect to the head affects responses in the superior colliculus to tactile stimuli. So here's an example of a neuron in the superior colliculus that was responsive to a tactile stimulus as well as to the eye movement to the location of that tactile stimulus. This is a graph of the average firing rate of the neuron versus time. The tactile stimulus turned on here, and the saccadic eye movement occurred roughly in this period of time. And you could see that the neuron responded to the onset of the tactile stimulus and exhibited a burst of activity in conjunction with the eye movement to the location of that tactile stimulus. But more interestingly, these responses depended upon the position of the eyes with respect to the body part. So this is the activity pattern I just showed you. And this neural response was exhibited when the tactile stimulus was delivered to the left hand and the eyes were located in that position and about to make that eye movement. Here's what happened when we delivered the exact same tactile stimulus and simply moved the eyes to a different position. So now the eyes are up here and a downward and leftward movement is going to be required to look to that tactile stimulus. And here's the activity pattern of the neuron under those circumstances. There's quite a big difference between the response over here for this configuration of eye position with respect to the body than over here. This suggests that the superior colliculus plays a role in coordinating between vision and touch, and in particular, in synthesizing the information from the different joint angles that the brain needs to evaluate in order to figure out how to direct the eyes to the location of the tactile stimulus. Coordinating between vision and touch is one of the problems that the brain faces when trying to combine information across different sensory systems. And another equally important issue is how do we combine what we see and what we hear? And that's what I'll talk about in the next video.